Not all over-the-counter, OTC, pain medications are appropriate for everyone. There may seem to be dozens of choices on store shelves, but there really are only two main types of over-the-counter, OTC, oral pain relievers, acetaminophen and NSAIDs, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Furthermore, NSAIDs has several types, ibuprofen, naproxen sodium, aspirin, acetyl salicylic acid, and diclofenac. Understanding the differences between them could matter to your health. Examples of each type. Examples of acetaminophen are Tylenol, Actimen, Feverol, Panadol, Tempra Kicklets, Dayquil, NyQuil. Examples of ibuprofen are Advil, Midol, Mortirin, Neoprofen, Ultraprin. Examples of naproxen sodium are Aleve, Anaprex, Motrimax, Naproxen. Examples of acetyl salicylic acid or aspirin are Bayer, Bufarin, Empirin, Genacote, Miniprin, Unibuff. Examples of diclofenac is Voltaren Mulgal, which is applied topically. Note there are many combination products. Contains ibuprofen, ibudun, reprixane, vicoprofen, Combinox. Contains aspirin, Alka-Seltzer, Excedrin. Contains naproxen sodium, Vimovo, Trixamet, acetaminophen, Tylenol, Info. Acetaminophen's mechanism of action isn't fully understood, but it seems to increase your body's pain threshold, the point at which sensation is perceived as painful. So it provides pain relief, may be given to infants, and is available as a pill, chewable tablet, liquid, and suppository. May not be used in children with liver abnormalities or medications affecting liver function. In children scheduled for surgery, it may be used right up until surgery. Ibuprofen, Advil and Motrin, Info. Ibuprofen is a short-acting NSAID that starts working faster than naproxen. This may be better for acute pain, like a new injury. Ibuprofen has fewer side effects than some NSAIDs but can cause heartburn and a rash. It should be avoided in people with kidney or liver problems and may increase the risk of hypertension, high blood pressure, and heart attack if taken excessively. It provides pain relief, works as an anti-inflammatory to reduce swelling, and is longer acting than Tylenol. It is available as a pill, chewable tablet, and liquid. It needs to be taken with food or milk. Should not be taken if a child is vomiting, dehydrated, or not eating much. May not be used in children with gastrointestinal or kidney abnormalities or with medications affecting kidney function. May not be used 72 hours prior to surgery. May not be used in patients under 6 months old. Naproxen, Aleve, Info. Naproxen is a long-acting NSAID, meaning it takes longer to relieve your pain but remains in effect for longer than a short-acting NSAID like ibuprofen. You also don't have to take it as often. This can make it a better choice if you need to take it regularly for pain from a chronic condition. Another real advantage is that naproxen sodium is associated with fewer side effects than ibuprofen, meaning it's safer overall and you may be able to tolerate it if ibuprofen bothers you. Compared to ibuprofen, naproxen has a far higher risk of stomach ulcers. It provides pain relief, works as an anti-inflammatory, and is longer acting than acetaminophen and ibuprofen. It is available over the counter in pill form and by prescription in liquid form. May not be used in children with gastrointestinal or kidney abnormalities or with medications affecting kidney function. Needs to be taken with food or milk. May not be used 72 hours prior to surgery. May not be used in patients under 2 years old. Which one to use? Below are what to take for common issues between the two major types of acetaminophen, Tylenol, or NSAID, Advil, Motrin, Aleve. Headache, acetaminophen, Tylenol. It provides quick pain relief and is safer to take more for longer periods if your symptoms last. Inflammation, ibuprofen, Advil, Motrin, and naproxen, Aleve. The most common of the non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, NSAIDs, ibuprofen, or naproxen inhibits the chemicals that cause inflammation in the body. It's the pick for things like sinus infections, arthritis, earaches, and toothaches. Fever, either acetaminophen, Tylenol, or NSAID, Advil, Motrin, Aleve. Some people find relief from acetaminophen, others from ibuprofen. If your fever is accompanied by an upset stomach, take acetaminophen. Ibuprofen and naproxen may make your stomach feel worse. Muscle aches or strains, ibuprofen, Advil, Motrin, and naproxen, Aleve. Its anti-inflammatory properties are better for muscle soreness and body aches that typically stem from inflammation. Cold or sore throat, acetaminophen, Tylenol. Some studies show that acetaminophen relieves cold symptoms and a sore throat better than ibuprofen or naproxen. Pain, either acetaminophen, Tylenol, or NSAID, Advil, Motrin, Aleve. Acetaminophen is a pain reliever. Ibuprofen or naproxen acts on inflammation, which can be the root of your pain. Take the one that provides you comfort and try the other pill if your pain persists. Menstrual cramps, ibuprofen, Advil, Motrin, and naproxen, Aleve. NSAIDs inhibit the production of prostaglandins, hormone-like lipids that cause your cramps. Acetaminophen only relieves the pain and doesn't reduce your levels of prostaglandins. Proper dosage. No matter which medication is used, parents must pay careful attention to dosing, especially to children. For the liquid form, parents should use the dropper or dosing cup that comes with the product. Kitchen spoons should never be used since they are not uniform in size. Mixing OTC pain relievers. You need to be careful when taking more than one OTC pain relievers. You shouldn't take more than one drug from a class at a time because it increases your risk of side effects or overdose. That means it's not safe to combine NSAIDs aspirin, ibuprofen, naproxen, or prescription NSAIDs. Because acetaminophen has a different mechanism of action, it can be safely taken with NSAIDs. Summary. These painkillers may all relieve the same symptoms, but they work differently in your body and have different active ingredients, warnings, and dosing directions. One type may be more appropriate for you, based on your age, health conditions, and other medicines you currently take. It's important to understand pain reliever differences so that you can help select an appropriate choice for you. It's important to look at the side effects and any potential drug interactions. When in doubt, check with a healthcare professional. If you are taking any medications, you can also ask the pharmacist in a drugstore for advice.